Welcome to the seventh section in our series on carbohydrates, and the section is discussing whole versus refined carbohydrates. Let's start by looking at some refined carbohydrates. The most common one that everybody knows is sugar. Remember, sugar or table sugar is sucrose, and this is a disaccharide. It's a very simple sugar. It's not just the sugar that you add to, say, your coffee or your tea, but this sugar or its varieties are found in many of the processed and packaged food products. Many of them are not even desserts. Cereals, packaged and processed cereals. Now, this is something that can surprise many people because we think of cereals as a healthy way to start the day. Although there might be a few cereals out there that could be defined as healthy, I would say 98% of them are not. If you think about what your cereal looks like, and we can look at this little puff here, it really has gone through a number of processing steps. And there are a lot of food additives, natural or artificial flavorings, as well as sugar added to the products. So when you go to grab for your cereal, the first thing I want you to do is look on the back of your cereal. What you'll usually see, you might see a whole grain on there, but remember that the further your product looks from how it existed in nature, the more refined or processed it is. And if you have a bran cereal, but that bran, which is our fiber component of our whole grain, and it's been pulverized to a fine powder to make it into this flake or O or puff, it's not really doing the job it's supposed to, even though it might list that it is a good source of fiber at 2.5 grams or more per serving. So you always want to keep that in mind, and also look and see how much sugar has been added to the cereal. Many of the cereals out there, even the kids' cereals, have an enormous amount of sugar. Generally, children start their day with more than their allotment of sugar for the entire day. They get it just at breakfast with the cereals. And don't be fooled by all the vitamins and minerals they throw back into the cereal. By law, they have to put in what they took out. So the refined carbohydrates that are when the carbohydrate is, the grain is refined, a lot of the nutrients are lost, most of them. By law, you have to put those back in. And then a lot of companies add even more vitamins and or minerals to make it look like a healthier food. But that doesn't necessarily mean it's healthier. It's like getting a dose of sugar, starch, and taking a vitamin supplement. Breads. This is another one, and I've talked about this a lot. It's a very refined product. If you had a bread that actually was made from whole grain, it would not be light and fluffy, it wouldn't be doughy, it would taste bitter, it would probably fall apart, or it would be a little bit crunchy, and we don't see many of those types of breads anymore. So most of your breads are highly refined. Pasta, of course, it doesn't take much to look at this and go, yeah, this, I'm not really sure how they came up with this from, this is probably a wheat noodle, from a wheat plant. It's come a long way to get here, and have these colorings added. So again, most pastas are very refined. And white rice. Now, wild rices, brown rices, those are more whole grains. White rice is polished, and it means that the good parts of the rice have actually been removed, and that leaves you with basically that light, fluffy white rice, which is mostly just starch. So the reason these are all considered refined is that they either are high in sugar or they have a very highly digestible form of starch, meaning the starch is going to break down really quickly and just become sugar in the system very quickly. So what is a whole grain? I have been talking about whole foods, whole grains. What exactly is a whole grain? Well, let's take this, and this can go for most grains. It's kind of the same. Each one, this one is specifically for wheat, but generally there is a husk on the outside, and then we have the bran, which is the fiber, the endosperm is the starch, and then this is the germ. That constitutes the whole grain. Now, the FDA has defined a whole grain as cereal grains that would consist of the intact, ground, cracked, or flaked kernel. Now, this is the kernel here, which includes the bran, so this is the shell with the fiber, the germ, and this is the innermost part of the kernel, and that's the endosperm. And the other catch that they have with their definition is that it needs to be in the same, when it's added to a food or it's in a food, it needs to be in the same proportions, meaning they can't say, they have to start with the whole grain and use all of its parts in either cracked or flaked or ground to be a whole grain. And looking at the actual grain here, we'll go through it, and I just named all the parts, but the husk is actually not shown here. The husk is actually toxic and it is always removed. So when we look at an actual wheat plant, you have to remove this husk in order to be able to eat the kernel. And that's why it took so long before we started eating grains. It's only been about 10,000 years ago when grains became a big part of our diet. The other 2.5 million years, we really didn't eat grains. Bran, this is the bran, this is the part that has the fiber, is the bran, mainly the fiber. The endosperm, this is the starch, so this is where most of the starch is going to come from. And lastly, the germ, which has our micronutrients and protein. I will say there are some micronutrients in the bran and tiny bit in the endosperm, and then some of the phytochemicals also, our phytonutrients can occur in the bran and then in the germ. So what happens during refining? Well, in refining, the bran and the germ are removed. So remember, the husk is always removed as toxic. The bran is removed and the germ are both removed. And what does that leave? It leaves the endosperm. So now we have this, just the starch, which gives us our white, fluffy bread. And I will say, and I should have mentioned this earlier, that the whole grain definition by the FDA, the FDA hasn't fully defined whole grains and exactly what constitutes a whole grain. So they just have that basic definition. So, but they have defined that once the germ and the bran are removed, then that is a refined grain. So you can't call it a whole grain. So at least that is good. Okay, so when you think about whole grains, I don't want you to think about bread. I don't want you to think about bran cereal. I want you to think about a grain, a whole grain that looks more like a kernel. And here's a whole list of different types of whole grains. It looks, you can see that this isn't processed into, a cracker. These are whole grains. So quinoa has become more popular, brown or wild rice, even corn or bulgur. But by far the most popular is wheat. But again, when you want to be eating a whole grain, when you think of whole grain, I want you to think about how it existed in nature. Of course, without the husk, we can't eat the husk. But as close as possible to how it existed in nature, not all of these, milled together and then thrown into, on top of a sprinkled on bread, so they can call it a multigrain. Now, because the FDA has not done a detailed job of defining whole grains in foods, the Whole Grains Council has come up with whole grain stamps. These are good in part because they can indicate if you're eating a whole grain food, but keep in mind that if you're seeing a stamp on a whole grain food, it is most likely a processed food. Also, this is an industry-supported organization. They do have some very good information on their website, though, about whole grains. You just have to be a little bit skeptical, and just make sure you do your research. There are two types of stamps. The basic stamp, which is shown here, and the 100% stamp. And their recommendation is to eat 48 grams or more of whole grains daily. Whole grains daily. And this is, it's kind of an arbitrary number, but it's not a bad recommendation. I'm not going to say it's a bad recommendation. So we don't have anything from the FDA at this point to say exactly how much we should be eating per day. We don't have those recommendations yet. So the Whole Grains Council has determined this. So shooting for this number, if you're eating grains, is actually not a bad target. The basic stamp, and what you see is that they look very much the same, except for the 100% has this 100% mark. The basic stamp means, well, let me start with a serving of whole grains means 16 grams. And so the basic stamp will indicate a half a serving of whole grains in the food that you're eating. Usually a serving of a carbohydrate type food is about 30 grams. The basic stamp says that there are 8 grams. So what you'll see is 8 grams or more per serving. And when you look at the 100%, it will say there are 200%. One will say 16 grams, so that means you're getting what they're calling a 100% of your 100% of a serving, 100% of a serving of whole grains within that 30 gram serving of your food product. And then they actually have a 47 gram or more. And this is usually the only stamp that will show you a truly whole grain product. So if we go down to here, you can see I have it labeled that the basic has 8 grams or more for 30 gram serving. That means that there are 8 grams of whole grain. And that could be in a bread, it could be in a cracker, it could be in a muffin. But really what you're getting is 27%. Of that product is whole grains. So that's what your basic whole grain stamp is. So less than 30%, that's not a lot. That means that the other 73% were fine grains. So that's not the best indication. Refined grains or other ingredients. Now the 100% means at least 16 grams or more of whole grains. And a lot of times it could be more. So 16 grams out of a 30 gram serving. So what is 16 in a 30-gram serving? Well, that means that 51%, at least 51% of that product that you're eating is whole grains. That means the other 49% can be refined grains or some of the other ingredients. So that's, again, giving a 100% stamp to something that could be only half whole grains is a little bit misleading. So you have to look at the fine numbers. You have to look for, if you're grabbing a product, 47 grams or more. Now this is actually, this 100% of 40 grams or more is a true stamp. That you're going to get that on a bag of wild rice. So that is good. So you can look for that. But all the other ones, stamps can be a little bit misleading, especially these basic stamps. If you see this on there, you're going to see that on, you know, cereals and crackers and muffins and all sorts of processed foods. So make sure you look for the 100% and, of course, the 47 gram mark. And at this point, we have to wait for the FDA to come out and give a little bit more detail on, you know, what constitutes a full serving of whole grains and how many whole grains do we need per day to be healthy. So when you're choosing a whole grain, again, like I pointed out, you want to make sure you're eating a whole grain. So with this, if you were to get that stamp and you saw the 47 grams per serving, this is 100% whole grain food. That stamp is going to be accurate in this case. Now let's say you had 100% whole grain bread. Well, it could have, you know, close to 47 grams, but it could have just the 16 plus grams per serving of whole grains, most likely. So that's not 100% whole grain, even though the stamp will show that it's 100% whole grain. It could only be 51% whole grain. So that's something to always keep in mind. Then there's the whole wheat bread. Or you could even see whole grain bread, one or the other. This is going to have the basic stamp on it for 8 grams per serving of whole grains, so 8 grams or more. This is definitely not a whole grain bread. So when you're getting that, it could be, you know, 27% whole grain and 73% processed refined products or processed refined grains. So again, whole wheat bread doesn't necessarily mean that it's whole, all whole wheat. And even 100% whole grain doesn't mean that it's 100%. If you are choosing, of course, between the two, you want to always look for 100% whole grain, and you want to see that in your very first ingredient. And it should have 5 ingredients or less if you are choosing a bread. And lastly, wheat bread is white bread. Probably no whole grains, made with white flour, usually caramel colored, sometimes molasses are added. This could have absolutely no whole grains in it. So just because a bread is dark doesn't mean anything. And also keep in mind that you can have 100% whole grain bread, but it goes back to the fiber we were talking about in the last lecture. You could take that fiber, you can take that kernel of wheat, and if you pulverize it down to a fine, really fine powder, make that bran a fine powder, you can have the fiber in there, but it's not going to do you much good because it's not in its intact form. So again, whole grains should be whole, and all of these are refined. And if you are going to choose a bread, look for 100% whole grain bread and make sure it's your first ingredient. There's very little added other ingredients, fiberless. Next time you pick up your bread, look on the back of the ingredients and count how many ingredients are in there. I think you'll be surprised. So again, whole foods, whole grains, they should look as close as possible as to how they did in nature. What are refined cereals and breads and pastas and crackers and muffins and bagels and all those wonderful, lovely, refined carbohydrates that taste so good. These are all refined. And they're the carbohydrates that are not going to be good for your health. So in the end, I'm going to continue saying what I have been saying is you need to eat real food.